getting a diagnosis of COPD can be a bit daunting and discouraging. And many times people start wondering, why did this happen to me? And why me? Why not other people who had the similar exposure or similar activities like myself? So today I'm going to talk about what are the causes of having COPD? What leads people to develop this condition in their life? Over the last few years, it has been increasingly recognized that COPD may not only be caused by smoking, and there are many other factors that play a role in developing COPD in anyone's life. This is also recognized in the new gold guidelines, where it talks about COPD taxonomies, that what's the reason behind people developing this condition. So here are a few things that contribute to developing COPD later in life. Smoking is the biggest risk factor for developing COPD, and up to 80% of the people who have COPD have had a smoking history in their past. But not all smokers develop COPD. About 20% of them end up having COPD in their life, and in some cases we see that it's up to 40 or 50% that would develop COPD. So this in itself tells us that smoking alone is not the factor that plays a role. There are other things that make some people more susceptible to develop COPD condition. And I should say that smoking exposure is not just limited to you yourself smoking, but also a secondhand smoking exposure. Another factor is prolonged exposure to air pollutants, irritants, fumes, and dust. This is more important for people who have long exposure to dust in mining and other industries that expose them to these fumes. High levels of air pollution in the urban populations and developing countries is also a big concern right now, because many children growing up in this polluted air will likely develop some kind of lung problems and may have a risk of COPD later in their life. Now, depending on which country you live in, sometimes there are other fumes and exposure that are more important as a risk factor for COPD than smoking. For example, in many developing countries, women are exposed to fumes from biomass fuels like burning wood and burning coal at their homes for cooking and for other reasons. And if they have a closed environment that's not well ventilated, that fumes and that exposure in itself is a big factor for causing COPD. And in some countries, up to 40% of COPD is related to such exposure. Another contributing factor is our genetics and our genes, which means that certain genes put you at a higher risk of being more susceptible of developing COPD. There's one specific gene, alpha-1 antitrypsin mutation, that has direct link to developing COPD. So people who have two gene mutations in this gene are very likely to develop emphysema early in their life. But other than that, there are also other genes that play a role that may not be very direct, but increase your susceptibility for developing COPD. So knowing the family history of lung diseases and lung conditions is also very important. Another factor is childhood infections. So sometimes children are born maybe prematurely, or they had lung infections early in their life that affected the lung growth. As we know that when we are born, our lungs continue to grow and grow even when we are in our teens and up to 18 years of age. So if someone has had infections early in their childhood, their lungs may not develop to the peak as would be expected in other people. With little damage, they can start experiencing the COPD symptoms because they don't have extra reserve lung capacity like other people. So avoiding early child infections and treating them promptly is very important for future lung health as well. And then lastly, uncontrolled asthma can also increase the risk of developing COPD. The damage in asthma is usually reversible, but if the inflammation is ongoing and it's not well controlled, the damage can evolve into COPD-like disease later in the life. Some additional factors also increase our susceptibility to lung damage. The damage from smoking is actually much more profound in women. So with less amount of smoking exposure, they might have the same amount of damage as men with more smoking exposure. So with that information, I think it's important for us to realize that not all COPD starts the same way. There are many reasons that can lead to a development of COPD later in life. Early recognition of these exposures and these risk factors can help us manage them, control them. Getting a diagnosis of COPD can be overwhelming, but I tell you, there are lots of support and new treatments out there that will help you manage your disease, let you gain control of your life and your breathing. Thank you for listening. Also, check out our small hands-free device, and I hope you will also find it very helpful, as many other people, in their symptom control and their quality of life.